Hello, good people. Goodly morning to you all. Or good day, I should say. Doesn't depending on what time of the day you watch or you're watching. Thank you for being here. Thank you for sharing. The little button down at the bottom there, please press it for me. I do appreciate it. I've doubled the number of my subscribers. I jumped from 7 to 14 subscribers last evening. Thank you. Thank you for joining me. I really appreciate it. This is the last day of this particular piece. And I shall have at it forthwith. Let me first take a sip of my tea. And contemplate where I'm going to begin today's session. Yes. All righty then. So it's going to be some line work. I have put a big canvas down on the floor here, but that's now getting in the way of my wheels. No matter. I just wanted to finish off the foamy bits on this surface here, and actually let's just not confuse ourselves. Finish this off nicely. With a bit of charcoal just to darken the around the edges, and then I'll continue with some white pastel. And there's my mosquito that I didn't kill yesterday, somehow. Right. So, this line work, this contrasty line work. another sip of tea. Just in the distance here, up to the horizon line and so on, these long she wanted to stand up and right. That will do. That will do for the near. Right. Okay. So enough of that then. Let me come back to my working with my contrast. Where's that little piece going? There we go. Right. Needed here now is some white contrasting. First of all, cup some tea. Some white lines. So, lines, the lines. The line work is gives form, it is the topography for this piece. Is the punctuation just the merest flick in intensity of the line can create something very different, just like you would with punctuation. You can create completely a completely different meaning and implication to what is being told. My Conte crayons, of all of these mediums that I use here, the chalk pastel, the charcoal, and my Conte crayons, these can get the thinnest line. Not that thin, not as thin as you could say with pencil or pencil crayons or something like that, but at least, and you can get quite a gentle line as well, because it's fairly hard. This is quite hard, this crayon. So you can get a very faint line coming off it without, you know, if you not too much pressure, and get exactly the kind of line that you want, and just as you move across the surface, so you build that line very faintly, and it just nicks here and there and just brings that little additional highlight that I'm looking for here. As I said, it creates form, so it now brings more meaning to the surface that I'm trying to translate here. So the variety of patterns on the surface of the water in this particular part here is different to over there. This way a little bit more, and then the pattern stretches out a little bit more. The lines that I'm using are a little bit more pressure. But I'm traversing the whole surface. Using more of an edge, more of the a broader stroke than a thinner line. It's still a line though. And here as well, much smoother surface, longer strokes. Still kind of crisscrossing though. Right, now I'm going to move into this part of the wave. Before I do though, bars of tea. So if you can imagine what's happening here, there is a, this is that's a wave there, those are waves back there, they're all coming in this way, past us, this way. This is one wave, however, what we've had here is a back surge of water. From the previous wave, it's run up the beach, far up the beach, so it's a steep beach if you can imagine. I mean, just picture the scene. So you've got this trundling surf that comes in here. Not very heavy surf, quite fairly gentle, but maybe 3 foot waves. Surging up the beach and then washing back down again, meeting the next incoming wave. And creating this surge, this eruption right in the middle of the wave that it crashes back into. So so yes, creating this sort of extra double sort of mid-wave wave type of thing. That's just the gist of what's going on here. So I'm going to get these little subtle streaks on the surface of the water. And of course behind this wave is now it's getting into shadow, but there's lots of aerated water behind. So it hasn't broken, but it's underneath the surface, but it's inside, not inside, it's on top. That sort of stuff. So almost as if you would look at the veins of a leaf or the palm of your hand, there's this intricate pattern of lines that give it its character, that tell the story of motion, of what exactly is happening with this piece, and you can just picture it. Picture it all happening, coming together. Let's just also use a little bit of this pale lilac. I want to use the pale blue, it's a little bit too light, but also it goes this goes nicely with the white of the Conte, a little bit of do something slightly darker as well. Is that your door? Okay. Let's leave that for the time being. Shift over here a bit. Right. This is now where some quite serious disruption is taking place. So my line work changes from short streaky directional to long streaky over there to kind of a little bit wavy over here to all over the place down here. I'm just going around and about with this line. I'm just building it up slowly. I need to work to the bottom. Also, at the same time, some much fainter line work, some heavier line work. And I'm rolling around, I'm rolling this contact crown around in my fingers as I work. To get that, because it's square, so I get a nice little jiggly line. Smudge here and there as well, just to take the edge off it. Softer lines, much softer pressure, less pressure. Just need lots of knots and lots and lots of lines traversing the surface of this, because there's lots of stuff going on, and little bits of foam and what have you, little eruptions of of this. I need another piece of charcoal. I need a little piece, but I need a broader piece. None of those. that one maybe. Use a little bit of my pastel here, and I'm going to just very faint. I'm going to smudge it out. I just need that little. A little bit more line work now with my chalk pastel. Also very squiggly. So I end up with this quite a hectic sort of spider web of line that I can also, you know, smudge and smear and right, now I need to work this up a little bit. Peeling off here. certainly been going through whites lately. A lot of white seascapes and skyscapes, actually, demand a lot of whiteness. Lovely little splashes over here, just off the, almost off the page. Just a little bit of detail there happening. All line work. Right. Let's do a little bit more over here. Contact for this, I think. Some tea. bit of green over there, I think. Just over here. Now I'm going to just add a few lines in white pastel. Just very, very subtly changing that contrast over here. Right. Righty-ho then. Righty-ho. That's what I need. Okay, time for some paint and some splatter. The matter of splatter. Right. Let me get my faduk here ready as well. Let's get those out the way. Come here. Right. And my little splatter guards. Let's me actually put that over my knees so I don't have to squirt myself. Okay. Okay, let's dip that in some water to begin with and start. Slightly different splattery bits from, and I have no idea how this is going to turn out, by the way, just saying, at this stage. It's dropping on the plate. You see, that's why I needed to have bring my, stop it you git. Okay, so clearly no water is necessary to add. Right, let's go. I wonder what this will do. Let's see. Wait, let me just do this quickly. Right. No, not quite. See? Let's try with this brush. This is a really... I don't know where this brush came from, actually. It's a real cheap and nasty one. but, hell. No ways. It's a Faber. Oh, it's got an eraser on the end. What the hell is that thing? Gosh, I don't know where that came from. I honestly don't. Must have been with me for decades, but nevertheless. Let's see if I can splatter with this one. Even. Ah, you see now, that's looking. That's quite a nice splatterer as well. This brush as well. Let's see what that one works out to be like. Let's put some more paint in there. A little bit there. Okay. Come on, puppy. Let's see what you can do here. There we go. Very, very nice, Peter. Don't I just bring my paint thing over here so I can work straight off there. See, I need, I don't want soft brushes for this because that will give it too regular an application. For this, I need a rough, bristly end, and that's what I've got. This over here, I'm going kind of, you'll see that I'm going upright here. It's where this wave has just like met another wave coming back, and it's just squirted upwards almost. But it's also kind of fanned out. Like the crest of a cockatoo. getting there. I think this paper will buckle a little bit with all the saturation, but it will hold it because it's 600 micron, 390 grams, so it's a heavy paper. It's thicker than a business, much thicker than a business card, if you can imagine. So it can take quite a lot of quite a load of a saturation. And that's one of the reasons why I like working with it so much. It takes a real beating. Right, let's employ my trusty toothbrush again. Let's really get some good stuff going in there. Is loads and loads of spray up here. Ah, in fact, it goes way up. Well, I can't account for what's behind here, so I'll just have to wipe surfaces of cupboards and things afterwards. At least it's acrylic, so it is easier to get rid of. Don't do that. Okay, that can be removed afterwards, it's fine. I'm trying to get too clever here. That is my problem. These little wayward pieces of bits of paint that has dropped here and there, they will not really, until they, well, they even once they dry, they won't really stick 100% to the chalk pastel and charcoal beneath. So they're quite easy to just pick off when I'm done. It's enough of that for now. Let's get my fingers wet. Oh, just need some more paint here. See that one, that little dribble is, oh, that one's already fine. I'll just pick it off later. That one's fine. Hey, Mark, Fish, if you're watching, happy birthday, my friend. Happy 50th. Hope it's a brilliant one. Yeah, it's quite a marker, this one, isn't it? 50. So I hope you have a fantastic day, my friend. Mark Lewis and I go back many a long year. Years, in fact, when we started studying graphic design together. Yeah. Anyway, have a joyous day, my friend. More work down here now. Let's take this. So, this is getting quite saturated now, and it is starting to buckle a little, but it will, as it dries, it will flatten out again. As expected. Kind of getting there. That's kind of the gist of it, eh? Yeah, this is it's always unpredictable when you start to work with this kind of thing. So it's actually, I'm just going to let go of it and just let it take its shape as it will. And it's doing just fine. Quite happy with the way this is turning out. We're going to go over time. Right, I think I'm done with the paint. Right, guys. Chalk pastel. Paint's starting to dry, and we've got this lovely, with the spray, it's given me a really nice, because it doesn't dry sometimes quite white, which is perfect, because now I've got the spray area that is now very rough. So I can just add these lovely little tendrils with the white chalk pastel. Let's get some, just gives that idea of a little bit more detail, and it's quite subtle. Right, and I think that that's done. How about that? How about that? There's a little piece of, just see if I can. Yeah, there's a little piece there, a little dribble there, that I will just pick off once it's dry. It's all good. Anyways, now we're done. I need to sign off. So, what's to use? Something a little bit more subtle than, let's try and use my charcoal for a change, because I don't want it to be black, starkly. Yep. 20, 21. There we go, peeps. That's turned out quite well. Quite happy with that. Righty, guys, we're 5 minutes over time. So, thank you for joining for this week. Thank you to my new subscribers. Thanks for pulling in. I really appreciate it. You don't need to always have to watch the full hour in every session. It's up to you entirely, of course. I appreciate any feedback that I get, so be my guest, please. You know, engage with me. I really enjoy that. And thank you for sharing my work as well. Those of you who do, it's fantastic. Thank you so much for getting me out there, spreading the word. So yeah, have a good one. Enjoy your weekend further, and I'll think of something, of course, for next week. I'm not sure what yet. Hey, it could be anything. It could be another seascape. I don't know. I'm on a bit of a roll at the moment, but see how that goes. Yes, so have a fantastic weekend, people. Oodles of toodles. And catch you again next week. Yeah, so take it easy. Be good. Bye.
Don't forget to doodle.